I need to add a bulkhead to my 180-gallon sump. This will help me do the second part of my completely automatic water change system for the 2,000-gallon aquarium as well as the 375. The bulkhead allows water to pass through a panel. This goes on the inside with the gasket, and then this holds it in on the outside. Now you guys, I've taught you a number of times how to drill a glass aquarium. It's easy to drill a glass aquarium. If the aquarium glass you're drilling is face down and there's no water or fish depending on you doing it properly. So today we're going to drill into this 180-gallon sump while it's filled with water and running and supporting the 375-gallon life support system as well as the 2,000-gallon housing tens of thousands of dollars in fish, but I'm going to show you how to do it anyways. I'm laughing because, well, saying this stuff out loud is kind of comical, but I've done this before. It's not that hard. It's pretty much the same. A lot of the times you just need water. So we're gonna have a little spray of water. I've got a towel below where I want to drill. You typically want a template, which is basically a piece of wood with your hole cut in it. Then you clamp it to where you want to cut and that are where you want to drill, and then that just holds it steady. But when drilling up and down, a lot of those things do not, no longer are that practical. So come here. We're gonna start off by using a diamond coated hole saw that is just slightly bigger than the neck of your actual bulkhead. So basically this fits in and kind of, it's a little bit loose, but it's not going to be bigger than the flask or the this lip around it. Typically speaking, you start off straight down, but in this case, we have to go at an angle because if I just go straight onto it, it's gonna jump all over the place. So I'm gonna go in on a bit of an angle. Let's speed up a little bit. I'm looking to create that groove there. We also wanna keep it continuously wet. Speed the drill up a little bit. You don't want to go too crazy though. Now, unfortunately, I have to come in at a bit of an angle, so I'm going to cut through one side before I even get to the other side. So I got to be very careful here. I think I'm through on a few of it. Unfortunately, like I said, because I'm coming at it from this angle, it's going to go through on certain sides than others. But a lot of times you also want to take your drill away and spray out all the debris. That's sand inside there, essentially. The pressure that I'm adding, I might be putting on 3 to 5 pounds, maybe 3 pounds. Want to put a piece of tape on the other side to catch the little circular disc that you're cutting out, but I'm not too worried about that with this. See, it didn't pop through. It didn't do anything crazy like you might have been expecting. Nice and slow. Keep it absolutely soaked, and you're gonna get a perfectly round piece. And I was lucky enough to catch it. I usually catch them anyway. Now we've got a hole exactly where I need it to be, and that's where I want the water level in the sump when I'm doing my water changes. Now we can move on. That took about 15 minutes. And that's something you're gonna have to consider if you're gonna drill a tank that's filled with water and fish, and it's really important that while you don't break it, go slow, take your time. Half inch glass took me 15 minutes to drill through. I stopped, I'm filming, I'm moving the camera around, I'm talking, I'm making sure, so maybe 10 minutes really, or 8 minutes, but it's not something that's immediately that happens. Take your time, keep the drill wet. Put a towel on the floor like I do and keep spraying it. If you can't do it and you need to hold the drill steady, have somebody else sit there and literally soak the drill bit. Trust me, I've drilled hundreds and hundreds of holes. I was laughing at the fact that it sounds crazy that I'm drilling this when it's filled with water, but that's exactly how you do it. You never really see that. I also did it freehand, but imagine this being what we were drilling into. I need to drill a hole through here. I started on edge. I start off, I create myself a little groove. As soon as I have a groove, I slowly start straightening it out until the whole thing has a groove of its own. And we can start pushing in. Pushing in, I mean, I think the drill might weigh 2 pounds, 3 pounds, so that's kind of all you gotta do. So long as it's creating that milky water that's coming out of it, that means you're drilling through it. If you're continuously spraying, it's just clear water, push a little bit harder. But once you can see, and keep looking in the back, but once you can see that the drill is almost all the way through, no longer pushing, we're just going nice and slow. Otherwise, you might create like shards or cracks or something like that. It's not that crazy, and definitely, at the very least, please don't drill through a tempered glass. You cannot do that at home. With the bulkhead in, I can move along with my completely automated water change system, where I'll never have to change the 375 gallons water manually ever again. That's gonna house my freshwater stingrays. Nor am I going to have to change the water on the 2,000 gallon aquarium, which we're turning into a true monster tank. And if you wanna see any of that, you're not subscribed to this channel yet, I highly suggest you do, or you're going to miss it. Also, don't do this in a hot environment and wear a sweater. It's not a good idea. I could have just sweat all over the hole and that would have been enough for the drill. Hope you guys learned something from this video. I do think that a lot of things I might do or teach you, it makes you nervous, but trust me, if you just listen to me and you follow my instructions to a T, you will have the equal amount of success as I do. See you guys in the next video. Now, just to give you an idea on how close I needed this to be to here, watch this. This is not the pipe that's going in, but it is a 3/4 inch pipe. Now check out the clearance. Absolutely perfect execution. Freehand. Don't do freehand a lot. You know, a lot of the times you wanna mark off where you're going to take a little bit more time on where you're gonna wanna put your hole. You might wanna mark off with an X. You might want to, you know, even take a pipe and see what it's gonna look like, etc. For me, I've been doing a lot of this stuff so long that I'll be honest, I sometimes forget some of the steps that I should be showing, but there you go. Perfect.